And that got me checking out this story of this girl who's from Philadelphia who lives now in Idaho. She spent a night in Idaho where she faced sub-zero temperatures, minus 33 degrees Fahrenheit. She's got to wake up in her car every few hours and start it.
Wow.
Her contact lenses froze completely.
Oh, you know, man.
I admire people that this girl's from Philadelphia, and she decided 6 years ago that she was going to move into her car and see the country. And that's what she's doing. Her name is Rosa.
That's the best plan, Rosa.
I don't know if it is either, but
sounds like it's a lot.
You should see her. She's documenting everything. She wanted to go to a hot spring in Idaho, and she had a night in her car where the temperatures dipped to minus 33 degrees Fahrenheit.
That's dangerous.
It really is. And she shows herself heating up a pot of chili and then scooping it out with tortilla chips while sitting in her car. She shows you her
contacts
frozen. Of course you could. She's got to wake up every couple of 2 or 3 hours and start her car to get things moving. She says,
I don't like this. This is not the best plan. You could find a spot to stay for the night.
Right. She says, I got to wake up throughout the night and turn my car on, let it heat up just so everything doesn't have a chance to freeze, because it can be really hard on your engine and the fluids and everything when it's this cold. And I'm wondering, 410-338-1098, I know it's probably not a proud moment, but anybody out there sleeping in their car or van or spend some nights in the Walmart parking lot, you know, it's tough.
I did. I was going. It was a snowstorm, actually.
Yeah.
And I was going to do a noon show 6 hours away, stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
And I left from Rochester to this place, but I thought I need to get there by noon, and it was 6 hours. I had to get a hotel. And so the hotel was disgusting and freezing, and there was, like, hairs everywhere.
Yeah.
So I opted to stay in my car. It felt cleaner.
Well, that's different, because you could have gone back in
to
a dirty hotel.
Yeah, but it was cold in there. It was, like, gross and dirty.
Right.
So I slept in my car. I mean, you know.
You toughed it out, even though you had a room.
Well, she sounds like she's chose it, right?
Well, yeah, she's 6 years on the road doing this.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So at 2:30 in the morning, she wakes up, turns her car on, and it was 26 degrees. And then at 6 o'clock in the morning, she wakes up again. Oh. This time it's minus 33 degrees outside. And, yeah, man. She
minus
turns her
33. Wait,
minus 33 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah, that's intense.
Not 33. That'd be a little bit above freezing.
Yeah.
Minus 33.
Yeah.
She says she turns her Starbucks coffee over a block of ice. But then she makes it to Idaho, and look at her. Slide into a hot spring right there. There she is. She's living what they say is her best life. But she says one thing. She says, when it comes to snow and winter, I guess you kind of do have to get used to changing your plans.
Mm-hmm.
She said she drove one spring, 2 hours away, and it was surrounded by ice and snow. It wasn't for her. Breathing kind of hurt.
Yeah.
She made her way back to her car and went to another one, and she found that one to be a little more to her liking. But if you were able to sell off your stuff, fit everything you need in your car or your van, and hop from place to place, you don't need anybody. You're meeting people.
Yeah, I'd probably choose to, during this time, not be in the northern states. Maybe plan it differently.
Well, she's not scared. Look at her.
She
gives you
a little
cheeky shot right there.
Yeah.
She's probably hooking up with cowboys out there in Wyoming and Idaho.
Stanks.
Going to Seattle next.
Gary from Hamden, what's the coldest place you ever slept?
I say Baltimore City Jail.
Really?
It was so cold in there, and the windows were broken out in the wintertime, and I had to put a trash bag on my body to keep warm.
All right. What did you do to be in the Baltimore City Jail and it was cold sleeping in the trash bag?
Robbed a drug dealer.
Oh, did you?
Well, you're lucky you got jail, actually. Robbed a drug dealer. So you're like, thank you, sir.
Robbed a drug dealer. I can't get too mad at you for that.
You know, I thought jails, they had to maintain a certain amount of, you know.
They don't.
Really?
What are you going to do? Say, I'm pissed. Look, they left the window open. Yeah, you
not Baltimore City Jail.
No, you kind of get what you get. Hey, Gary, thanks a lot, man. Fly straight, buddy. Yep.
Glad you're out. Caleb from Baltimore.
Hey, Caleb.
Would you sleep in a cold car? Hi.
Hey, yeah. I was a security guard for a while, and during one of the blizzards, we got snowed in. We ended up doing like a 72-hour shift, like out in the snow.
Yeah.
So we ended up bringing like little candles and like lighting them in the car to stay warm so we didn't run out of gas and bringing food with us.
So you're a security guard, so you had to stay in your car?
I was at the time, but yeah, we got snowed in, so we had to stay on site because the roads off site weren't plowed yet.
If you do something wrong or something that you're not expecting, you could die. I mean, if you're, let's say your exhaust pipe clogs up and you start breathing carbon monoxide or whatever,
right?
You just don't know. You're trying to stay warm. People
I'm surprised
do that,
your boss
dump stuff all
will
the time.
Let you. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely a concern. So, I mean, we kept an eye on it, kept snow shovels with us, but yeah, it was an adventure.
Hey, man, thanks for checking in.
Thanks, Caleb. That's really cool. Wow, I'm really
it's not as sexy as the way Rose is
doing it. Grateful for this job right now.
You know, her name is Rosa from Philadelphia, and she decided 6 years ago she was going to sell her stuff and live in her car. She's out in Idaho, and she said, I know it's going to be, I know the low tonight is around minus 25, but with the wind chill, they're saying it could go as low as negative 40, but I'm in my car, so the wind chill should not affect me, but if I tried to cook outside, it definitely would, she reasoned. And we got people on the phone.
Yeah, Josh from Baltimore. What's up? You live in a cold, cold car at some point?
Yes, I live in a 98 Honda Civic, a little tiny car. I have traveled a lot of places. I usually go to West Virginia and between Maryland, and it's gotten negative 30 in my own car, and the amount of breath I can see in my car is ridiculous.
Weird.
Having to find some place when it gets cold that's open and warm is difficult, especially when you're in Ronsford, West Virginia.
What do you got? You got a bunch of blankets? What is your method?
My method is kind of, it's three blankets, but I got a little air mattress to kind of fit in the back seat.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 22. I actually have two kids that I have to take care of. They don't live in my car, but I definitely go and support them.
Oh my goodness.
Dude.
Yeah, I do photography for income. So, you know, it's a life, but it definitely gets cold.
Hey,
right,
man.
Do you have hopes for settling down at some point?
I'm trying to make enough money to maybe get a better car or to try and pay for an apartment. But, you know, right now, this is what I got to do.
Hey,
listen, you come and take some pictures of me. I'll give you $200, all right? I'm serious.
Hey, if you're willing to, hey, contact me, I will. I'll make you look good.
Get his number, would you, Will?
Do you do... nature, like what do you focus on for photography?
Yes, I mostly focus on nature photography.
Kirk, can you
outdoors,
like
I travel.
Can you picture Kirk frolicking in the woods naked to make it more natural?
I'll throw a snowball at you.
Yeah, I can do that.
Nice. We'll figure now something. We're talking.
Damn right.
New promo pick for you. All right, we're gonna put you on hold. We'll get your info, and
thanks,
Kirk,
Josh,
will get a little photo shoot with you. Gary from Rosedale. Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
I didn't realize so many people had. What's your deal?
So when I first got out of the Navy, I was down in Florida, and I decided I wanted to try and stay down there. Didn't really have a place to stay, so I lived in the back of my pickup truck on the beach for about a month and a half, 2 months.
Mm-hmm.
Quite fun.
Was
enjoyable.
It? Yeah, weather's fine. I mean, if it's nice and warm, you're probably not alone. I'm sure there's others that do that.
Oh, salt life was a blast.
I was going
to
say,
hang out with them.
It's almost sexy in the beach living out of the back of your pickup truck. But yeah, let it turn into December and it's not so sexy anymore.
Yeah, it got a little chilly and I was like, yeah, I'm going home. Got alone and came home.
Salt life is over.
I'm going home. Yeah, that salt life turns to salt on the road.
You got to go.
Thanks, Gary.
Take it easy.
Thanks, bud.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting to see people that choose the life and those that have no choice.
I know. A lot of people have no choice.
Right now, rent is kind of bonkers. Selling houses, it's the way to go if you can sell. But the question is, where are you going to go?
Hey, during the pandemic, people were selling and getting an RV, just like the RV show's coming up. We got tickets for the RV show. That's where you just unplug and you hit the road. And wherever you are, if you can get Wi-Fi, you can do your job.
Mm-hmm.
So go to Idaho and find a hot spring.
Except for us. We
can't. Find Rosa.